Hi there. Welcome to Teachers Tech. My name is Jamie, and it's great to have you here today. Exclamation mark. Pause dictation. So you can see I'm practicing a little voice typing with Microsoft Word here today. Now it can do a lot more than just adding simple punctuation and writing what you say. You can do formatting, you could be adding lists and tables and so much more. So today on Teachers Tech, I want to go over and show you how powerful this voice typing by using Dictate in Microsoft Word is. So first of all, where are you going to find Dictate in Microsoft Word? Well, you're going to find it under the Home tab. So take a look at the tabs, make sure you're under Home, and in the ribbon on mine, go all the way to the right and you can see Dictate's right here. So you can click on it and it will open up and it's starting right away. The other place, it does work online too. So if I go to my Microsoft Word online and let me just open that up real quickly. You can see here's my online version. Here I am under Home and here is Dictate right here. And it's going to work very well from the online version too. So those are just where you're going to find it. Let's get started with some of the functions. I'll be working from the installed app on my computer on my desktop with Microsoft Word today. I just want to point out you can move this around. If you grab the top here, you get the move handles and you can place it where you would like. I just want to jump into settings real quickly because if you speak a different language, you might want to change this to get the best results. Now, click on the settings here and you're going to get the spoken language dropdown. You can see all the different languages that are available. Some they're testing out. They're always trying to improve this with Microsoft. Let me know in the comment if the different languages work well for you or not. Unfortunately, I don't speak any other languages to test this out. You can see where you're going to make sure you have the correct microphone selected, and then you have a couple toggles that you can turn on and off, and you can test those too to see how it works for you. So I'm just going to hit cancel. I'm just going to hit the start dictation here, and I'll just show you a good command that you might want to know. So if I go ahead and start this and just start talking. Today, we're going to be learning about how to use voice typing inside Microsoft Word. Delete. Delete that. Pause dictation. So you can see I used about three different commands there. I didn't put any punctuation in, and I'll go over the different commands in a moment. But you want to make sure that you do try to pronounce your words. I find if I just start talking, if I start talking too quickly, sometimes Microsoft Word dictation can't keep up. It does a very good job, but you know, you'll have to go through and format it, maybe correct some words, add some capitalization. This gives you an idea as I'm trying to talk faster to show you how much is there. Now, I showed you delete that. So delete that takes everything away of that last phrase because I never added any dictation, pause dictation. So you can see that time I said pause dictation too quickly and it just put it in as a phrase. If I say delete, it just takes away the last word. Delete that takes away everything. Now, I'm just going to open up this help here because this is where we're going to find all the commands here. And let's go over some key ones here. With punctuation, you just need to be saying that specific punctuation. So here's an example. If I go ahead and start using this period, how is your day today? Question mark. It's going great. Exclamation mark. Pause dictation. So you can see just to add in periods or question marks or exclamation marks is pretty easy. If you look over at punctuation here, you can see all the list here that you can do. So if I need a new line, you just say new line. So it'd be like this. New line. New line. Did you see how I created a new line there? Question mark. Pause dictation. So need a new line? Go ahead and just say new line. All these, I'm not going to go over all these, but you can see we have colon, semicolon, open quote, close quotes. It will just say take some practice in order to remember what to say on this. Now, let's move over to editing, take a quick look at the editing functions here. I already showed you a few here. I was saying delete and delete that. There's also undo, and you can see we have delete last and delete, so that's going to be the word or phrase. We have all these different things. All you have to do is say insert space, backspace, or backspace, and you give it a number in between here. So let's try this. Backspace 8. Pause dictation. So you can see it brought back the cursor 8 spots. So you can get very specific if you're trying to, if you're trying to format in here. All right, let's move down here. We're going to take a look at formatting. When you're using formatting, say it before you get saying your words. So here's an example. New line. Bold. Is this text bold now? Underline. Now whatever I say will be bold and underlined. Bold. If I say bold again, bold should be gone. Underline. If I say underline again, underline will be gone. So you can see, delete, pause dictation. So you can see if I say it twice, it turns it on or off, and they don't really say it very well at that point when you're just looking at this. So if you can say it beforehand, that's what I would suggest. If you need a list, that's no problem using dictation. You can just simply use these commands. Start number list. Cat. New line. 34%. New line. Winky faced. Pause dictation. So you can see I added some lists and I just made some quick comments about you could do symbols through these if you wanted to add things like percent. You can add all these different ones. So that would be more mathematical. But any of them, you can just say them as you go through. We can add currency by just saying dollar sign, the pound sterling, all these different ways. And you can see I added an emoji in here and you have a few different options for that. I do want to point out just some more information here about some tips. If you open this one up, you can see how I mentioned before, we can say delete that or delete. And they have a few different tips in here to take a look through. Go ahead and play with this now and see all the different things that you can try to see if this will actually be a benefit for you. Maybe it's a good way for you to kind of get your ideas out in here. The one thing I did want to mention, if you don't see dictate on your Microsoft Word, you do need to be a part of the have a Microsoft 365 subscription. So that could be why if you're not seeing it. Well, I hope you like these tips for using voice typing inside Microsoft Word this week. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.